Hello and welcome to Fun Stories. I hope you are all enjoying this wonderful summer weather that we're having these days. I have a story today called The Littlest Wolf, and this is one of my on loan books from Kate Helling. Thank you, Kate. This book was copyrighted in 2002, the words by Larry Dane Bremner, and the illustrations by Jose Erguero and Arian Dewey. Let's learn about The Littlest Wolf. It was a perfect summer morning. Big Gray was watching his pups frolic in a poppy-dappled meadow, but not all of them frolicked. One pup, the littlest, peeked out at the others from behind the trunk of a great gnarled tree. Do you know what a gnarled tree is? It's one that's got a whole bunch of bends and knots and everything in it. Not a straight trunk like we are used to seeing. Well, Big Gray ambled up beside the little wolf. He scratched softly behind his furry ears. "Little one, why aren't you playing with your brother and sister?" The little wolf began to fidget with an acorn that rested on the ground beside his paw. "Frankie said that I do not roll in a straight line," he said. Big Gray thought for a moment and he scratched his chin. "Straight lines can be a bother," he said. "Show me." "It won't do any good," thought the little wolf, but he curled himself into a ball anyway and rolled, feet over head, head over feet, again and again. The little wolf zigged. The little wolf zagged. The little wolf zigged and zagged. "See," he said to Big Gray, when he at last stopped rolling, "I do not roll in a straight line."
"No," said Big Gray. "Little one does not roll in a straight line like Frankie. Little one rolls in a line with curves."
Big Gray was thoughtful again and said, "That is just as it should be." "Are you sure?" the little wolf asked. "I am sure," said Big Gray. "Lines without curves come later."
"Well, that's good to know," said the little wolf, and he rolled to the middle of the meadow and back again, zigging and zagging all the way. But still, something bothered the little wolf. He tugged at Big Gray's fur, and Big Gray bent his head so the pup could whisper in one ear,
"Anna says I'm a slowpoke," the little wolf said. Big Gray looked out at the meadow where Anna was bounding after a monarch.
"Slowpoke, you say?" he scratched his chin. "Well, show me."
"It won't do any good," thought the little wolf, but he took a deep breath anyway and started to run. Before the little wolf had gotten very far, his run had become a galumph. And soon after, it was a toddle. He galumphed and toddled. He toddled and galumphed.
"See," the little wolf said to Big Gray when at last he came back, "I am a slowpoke."
Big Gray nodded. "It is true that Anna runs like the wind and you run like a soft breeze," he said. "That is just as it should be."
"Are you sure?" the little wolf asked.
"I'm sure," said Big Gray. "Running like the wind comes later."
"Well, that's good to know," said the little wolf, and he galumphed to the middle of the meadow and toddled back again.
"Big Gray," the little wolf started, but before he could finish, the words got stuck, so he pitched an acorn into the waving grass and then another. Big Gray rested his huge paw on the little wolf's shoulder. "What is it, little one?" he asked gently. The little wolf looked up at Big Gray.
Will I ever pounce as high as Tyler?"
"Tyler pounces as high as the oaks," said Big Gray.
"Tyler pounces as high as the clouds," said the little wolf.
Big Gray nodded. "Pouncing that high can be a bother," he said. "Show me your pounces." "Well, it won't do any good," thought the little wolf, but he crouched close to the ground anyway and sprang into the air. He pounced through the tall grass.
He pounced through waving poppies. He pounced onto a small pile of granite rocks and then off again. "See," he said to Big Gray when at last he was finished pouncing, "I do not pounce as high as the clouds. I do not even pounce as high as the oaks." "No," Big Gray said, "it is true you do not pounce as high as the clouds, but you do not need to. Your pounce is as high as the poppies, and," Big Gray nodded, "that is just as it should be." "Are you sure?" the little wolf asked. "I am sure," said Big Gray. "High pounces come later." "Well, that's good to know," said the little wolf, and he pounced through the grass and between the poppies all the way to the middle of the meadow and back again. And not once did he need to pounce as high as the oaks or the clouds. "You're right, Big Gray," said the little wolf when he returned, very pleased with himself. "I pounce high enough." "You certainly do," said Big Gray. Then they sat together in the warm summer sun, the big wolf and the little one, until the little wolf started to yawn. "I think it's time for a nap," Big Gray said, and he called the other pups to join him. Then Big Gray and his four pups lay together as a gentle breeze softly ruffled their fur. Big Gray looked up at the great gnarled oak above them. "Remember the acorns, little one," he whispered into the little wolf's ear. "They are just as they should be, and look what they become." What a good story about being little and growing into the things that you can't do when you're little. Poor little wolf was so discouraged that he couldn't do the things that his brother and sisters did, but he will grow and he will be able to do all of those things, just as Big Gray said. I hope you have a great day.